Hey there, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to take you through my portrait workflow, how I enhance an image. We're going to start off with this, then basically I just cropped it, then I enhanced it by doing some skin retouching. I am going to show you my new favorite way to do troublesome areas to something like this. So that's going to be our finished look. Let's get right to it. A quick PSA. So we are working on an image like this, but the actual original image was this. Oh man, did I ever make a mistake? I didn't check where Addison left all of her purse and water bottles and things like that, and it was in the background. That was a nightmare. I've already done a video on retouching tools, so be sure to check that out. That was a lot of cloning and stamping and all sorts of things. And even there, it kind of does look like a blob, but if you didn't see the before, you probably really never noticed the after. So the PSA is look before you click, right? Check your background, your foreground. Is there anything in there? It's so much quicker to remove things beforehand than to spend 20 minutes retouching things out afterwards. So let's get right to it. Okay, so this is the image we are going to work on. Let's go up to settings. We're going to get rid of the develop settings so you see how it was originally captured. We will also remove any effects that I have done. The only thing that's left is all the retouching I did to remove the plastic bottles and purse. Let's get to it. First thing we're gonna do is go into develop, and we're going to set the camera profile. I was shooting the Canon R5. I am going to choose just the standard profile for that. Exposure is good, contrast is good. If we take a look at how this was shot, it was kind of an overcast day late in the afternoon. So I'm shooting at f/2.8. I'm doing an 80-200 lens, and I was probably close to the 200 side. Shutter speed 1/500th of a second. I wasn't using a tripod, so I did bump my shutter speed up. Even though it has IS image stabilization, I still like to go a little higher on the shutter speed. So that made my ISO 1000. With the Canon R5, 1000 is still a pretty clean ISO. So all that I got right. What I didn't get right was checking
Denied.
the foreground and background for miscellaneous items. Ugh, that was no fun. Color and tone is looking great straight out of the camera. Next thing I'm going to do is look at the image and look at areas that I need to improve. A couple things that kind of bother me is even in my retouched areas, there is just kind of this dark area down here that stands out a little bit too much. In the background, there are these kind of dark spots. Most of it doesn't really bother me, but I'd really like to tone down this darkest one a little bit. And then skin retouching, and I'm gonna show you my new favorite method for this. Let's deal with the different things. I'm gonna hit the letter Q, come down to this corner. I'm just going to take that out if we can get that. Not real happy with how that's working out, so I am just going to hit the delete key and switch to Shift S, and that is going to bring up the clone stamp tool. I will hit Alter Option, and I have the opacity for that set at 80. I'm going to hit the Alt key to set the source, and then just paint in. So that looks pretty nice. I could use the same method for the planter. So I'm going to set a source. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. And then the last part is up here. And there are a couple ways that you could do something like that. One might be to go into local adjustment, hit lighten. But in this case, instead of exposure, I'm just going to kind of bring up the shadows a bit in the midtones and then paint over that area and try to blend it a little bit like that. And we can see the before and after. Even that's not looking super great, so I am going to try another method. Let's try with the letter Q, and Q is our healing brush. So I'm going a little bigger here. And the healing brush kind of leaves a little part in the highlight that I don't like either. So let's go back to Q and we can just delete that. So I'd like to try those first two methods first because those are non-destructive and easy to remove edits. Next, I am going to try the perfect eraser, and this is one that you can't easily step back in time. So we'll take a look at it. And that's not terrible. Bet you we can enhance that a little bit more. Okay, and that's looking nice there. All right, so we have the distractions from the background and the foreground all taken care of. The next thing is skin retouching. I'm going to use a new tool today. The reason for that is if we go to portrait, we'll see it doesn't do anything for the actual blemishes. So the skin softening in On One Photo isn't something that I typically use. I did make a video on how I would retouch those blemishes manually, but there is a new program that makes it so much easier that I am going to show you. So while I don't use the skin and we don't really need anything on the face, I will let the program do the eyes, and with the mouth, there's not really much on there. There are no teeth, so I'll just turn that down. And since I'm not even adjusting the lips or changing the hue, we can just turn that off. So once we have the image like this, I'm going to hit check, then the letter G to get back into the grid mode. So I'm now going to show you the new program I use for retouching the skin. I'll do another video and go really in depth into the program so you can see a lot of before and after. It's just is amazing. Not perfect, but amazing. So the new software for skin retouching doesn't take raw files, so we have to convert it. We could convert it to a TIFF, a JPEG, a PNG. Those are three formats that I know that it accepts. For this, I normally just make a JPEG. I think I can go to Shift D. And I will go to full res JPEG. And that's just going to save it into the same file. I'm going to add the name of the software I'm going to use just so that I know that's what's being used. Save it at 90% is fine. And we're going to keep the original resolution. So that is all unchecked. So let's hit export. Perfect. So here's the file that we're going to finish our work on. All I did was click on the green dot so we're out of the full screen mode. And that way I can start up this new software. And all I have to do is take this image and drag it into here. And it automatically works on it. This is all being done locally, so edits or photos are not being shared online. I'm going to enter full screen mode just so you can kind of take a look. There isn't much to this software. There's either the natural setting or the fashion setting. Since this is a fashion shoot for a talent agency, let's go with fashion. And then there's not much in the way of controls. You have general where you can reduce the amount. Let's zoom in a little bit. I'm just using the scroll wheel. You could go to the plus or minus in the bottom corner, but with the general slider, you could bring back detail or have it all the way. And same with texture. That's it. That's the only controls you have. But if we take a look at before and after, it just does an amazing job and it leaves the texture in the skin. Most of the time I do use natural. In this case, we're just going to go full blown fashion look. And then hit save. So we're back into On One Photo Raw. We're in the full screen mode. And here is the image. So let's take that back into develop by hitting the letter D. And while Rebellum did an amazing job, there are just two areas that I'd want to enhance a little bit more. So I'm going to hit the letter Q. One is just a very small area here. And I'm using the bracket keys to size the retouching area. That looks awesome there. Hit check. And now we're going to just finish up the image. All right, so with dark brown eyes, one thing that I like to do is just go into local, add an adjustment, hit vibrance, and even boost the midtones a little bit. Check my brush and it's painting in, and let's just take it down to about 30. Gonna make my brush a little bit smaller, and I'm just going to paint in the iris. So, and it's going to be more of a half circle, and the center part is going to be under that catch light. So I'm just going to kind of go right around there and right around there, and let's just bump that up a little bit so you can see it a little more. That is before. That is after. You probably don't see it very much on YouTube, so I'll just bring it up a little bit. Definitely dark brown eyes. So something like that. Might even just take the erase and just erase the very top part of that. Before and after, just a hint of color in her eyes. And actually, in a portrait like this, you're not even going to see it unless it's going to be a large wall portrait. So just wanted to share a technique, not necessarily something that you'd have to do with an image like this. I'm going to hit Command or Control 0 so we can get back to the full screen view. But what I would do is to finish off this with a couple of effects. First, I'll hit Add Filter. And then go down to LUTs, and let's give this a little bit of a color grade. On One has quite a few different LUTs that are included, and you can also add your own. I'm going to use some of the ones that are included for this. They have a great color grading section. And after you select the category, if you click on the LUTs and highlight it, you can just use your up and down arrow key and cycle through and see if there's ones that you'd like. So focus looks really nice. That's kind of a cool look. Keen is nice. Okay, so I'm going to go back to Keen and select that. Looking at the before and after, it's nice, but I may want to back it off. And the way that you do that is click on the gear icon, then up top under the properties window, you want to select blending, and then you can change the opacity. So now I can control the amount of the LUT being applied, and let's go with about 50%. Question I often get asked is, how do I get my properties panel 1 locked in over here, and how come it auto collapses like that? So what you want to do is go up to Windows, go to Properties, and make sure you have Show, Nest, and Auto Collapse. Nest is going to put it into the column on the right, and auto collapse lets it not take up so much space. So if we don't have that checked, it will always be like that. And when you're working through your effects and local adjustments, you have very little space. So go back to Windows, Properties, and I will have auto collapse. So the color grading looks great. Addison looks great. Let's just finish this off with a vignette. We'll do a big softy and take it back quite a bit. Once we have the image how we want it, just hit check mark and we are done. So in just a few short steps, we have a beautiful portrait of Addison. Skin is nicely retouched using the new program Reblum. If you'd like to check out that software, I'll have a link below that will also save you some money off of the program. I'll also have my On1 affiliate discount code for you so you can save 20% on On1 Photo Raw or any of the other products in the On1 marketplace. I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Leave comments if you have any questions. And if you have any ideas for future topics, be sure to leave those in the comments section as well. Thanks so much for joining me today. Until next time, keep shooting.